The traffic flow rate in cars per hour across an intersection is given by R of t, where t is in hours and t equals 0 is 6 a.m. We want to determine how many cars pass through the intersection between 6 a.m. and 10 a.m. Looking at the graph of R of t here on the right, for each specific value of t, we can determine exactly how many cars are passing through the intersection at that instant in time. But our goal is to determine how many total cars have passed through the intersection from 6 a.m. to 10 a.m. And since t equals 0 represents 6 a.m., we're concerned about determining the total number of cars from t equals 0 to t equals 4. The total number of cars passing through the intersection over this interval of time would be the same as the area under this function, or the area of this shaded region. And since this function is non-negative on this closed interval, we can determine the total number of cars passing through the intersection by determining the value of a definite integral. This is one reason why a definite integral is sometimes called the accumulation function. We can use it to accumulate the total number of cars passing through the intersection in this situation. So we want to determine the value of the definite integral from 0 to 4. Again, t equals 0 is 6 a.m., and since 10 a.m. is 4 hours later, t equals 4 represents 10 a.m. of R of t integrated with respect to t. So now we'll find the antiderivative function, and then we can determine the value of the definite integral using the fundamental theorem of calculus given here, where if big F of x is the antiderivative function, then the definite integral is equal to big F of b, where b is the value of the upper limit of integration, minus big F of a, where a is the lower limit of integration. So the antiderivative of 300 would be 300 times t plus the antiderivative of 600t would be 600 times t, this is t to the first, so it would be t to the second divided by 2, and then minus 90 times the antiderivative of t to the second, which would be t to the third divided by 3. We'll evaluate this at the upper and lower limits of integration. But before we do this, let's simplify. We'd have 300t. This would simplify to 300t squared and this would simplify to just 30t to the third. So minus 30t to the third. So we'll have some quantity when t equals 4 minus some quantity when t is 0. So when t is 4, we'll have 300 times 4 plus 300 times 4 squared minus 30 times 4 to the third. And then when t is 0, all these terms would be 0. So we're going to have 300 times 4, that's 1200 or 1200, plus 16 times 300, it'll be 4800, and then minus 4 to the third, that's 64, times 30, that's 1920. So we have a total of 4080 cars passing through the intersection from 6 a.m. to 10 a.m. I hope you found this explanation helpful.